And on this video, we continue to read the book, The Cash Flow Quadrant. And the message here, in fact, Robert is telling us that there are five levels of investors. And in this one, we are covering investor number one. Please join me. Hello, welcome to Take a Step to a Better You. Here I share what I know and continue to learn. If you're new, my name is Sherifa Nakalima. I'm based in Virginia, USA, business owner. And I'm very passionate about money topics, business topics, personal development, and motivation. So that's what I talk about. If any of that sounds interesting, please click on the subscribe button. See, it's red. If it's red, it means you haven't subscribed. If you are new, of course you haven't. So please consider subscribing, clicking on the bell also that comes up so that you get notified when I have new videos. For those of you who have said yes to this message I have here, appreciate you very much. Thank you. You know what to do. And in this video, Robert Kiyosaki, the one who wrote the book, The Cash Flow Quadrant, this one, but he also wrote Rich Dad Poor Dad. This one we finished. He's saying there are five levels of investors. By the time we finish, by the way, I'm covering just one of them in this video. So in the subsequent videos, I'll be going to number two, number three, until we finish all five. By the time we finish, I guess you will know where you are. Except, and especially this one, this first one, this one is an interesting one. So he called this one the zero financial intelligence investor. So if you don't have any financial intelligence, you'll be following in this one. Let's see what that person, how that person behaves like. So now, before I start all this, I always remind you my schedule. I'm here at 12:30 p.m. USA Eastern Time daily. On Friday, I switch it up when I come live, but the schedule is up there. On Thursday, also, I switch it up a little bit. I drive around. I have some fun videos when I drive around. I talk to some people. But the rest of them, for now, they are books. And then on Sunday, I do motivation. It's all clear up there. The book is The Cash Flow Quadrant. And the image for Cash Flow Quadrant, I always remind you, E stands for being an employee. That's how you earn your money. S, you are a self-employed person or you are a small business owner. On the right, you're a business owner or a big business owner. I should say big because it's bigger. It's not a small business on the left. And then on I stands for investor. According to Robert Kiyosaki, those are the ways we earn our money. And he's trying to show us, he's discussing the advantage and disadvantage of all of them. I mean, many of them. But the best are the B and the I on the right. So that's our goal. Now, this is video number 45. In 44, he gave us a difference. In fact, I added my 2 cents. The goals for investing. You could invest for cash flow or you could invest for capital gain. And I'm not explaining that again because I put my 2 cents on it too. That was video number 44. If you want to watch what the difference means, if you're ever going to invest, you need to know the differences. It's a pinned comment. I pinned the link in my comment on this video. When you say the top comment, it'll show you, take it to 44, the one we finished previously. If you want to get to this book, the audio is free, 1 month. The link's in the description. Audible, it takes you to Audible. And then also the book. If you want the real book, the link takes you to Amazon.com. And you can access these also through my own website. That's what is always up there, honestsoul.com. The last page is called Amazon Deals. That's where you access all that. And then if you want to watch all of them, the videos, remember this is number 45, I started on number one, same book. A lot of information, valuable information. If you are one of those people interested in money topics and business kind, invest those topics in the cash flow quadrant, please go find the link that takes you to all of them is in the description. I say all of them. It's called the cash flow quadrant. In the playlist, cash flow quadrant, at the end screen is, I think we've changed the end screen, is called financial management. When you go to this video is done at the end, that takes you to all of them. Okay, done with announcements. Now we are going to read, and the reading today, Robert Kiyosaki is saying that there are five levels of investors. And today I'm covering just one. I'm going to dedicate a video for each type of investor. So, five different levels of investors. Now I'm reading. There are five types of all levels of investors found in the I quadrant. Remember the I that was on the right? Level one, the one we are covering today, is called, he calls it, the zero financial intelligence level. Zero financial intelligence level. Sadly, he's writing, it's going to be a short read, by the way. Sadly, in America, once the richest country in the world, I didn't know it wasn't the richest anymore, over 50% of the U.S. population is at the bottom level of the I quadrant. Simply say, they have nothing to invest. There are many people who make a lot of money who fall into this category. They earn a lot and spend more than they earn. I have a friend who gives us an example. I have a friend who looks very, very rich. He has a good job as a real estate broker, a beautiful wife, and three kids in private school. They live in a beautiful house overlooking the Pacific Ocean in San Diego. He and his wife drive expensive European cars. When his son and daughters were old enough, they too drove expensive cars. They looked rich, but what they had was bad debt. They looked rich, but were poorer than most poor people. Now they are homeless. Oh, now I'm the one reacting. They're homeless. When the real estate market crashed. They were no longer able to pay the interest on all the debt they had accumulated. I'm about to end, by the way. When we were younger, this same friend made a lot of money. Unfortunately, it was his low financial intelligence level, zero, that caused him be a zero over the long term. I think I'm going to read this paragraph again. When you were younger, this same friend, the one he just described, made a lot of money. Unfortunately, it was his low financial intelligence level, which Robert called zero, that caused him be a zero over the long run. So he never changed. In fact, he's so deeply in debt that he's really a sub-zero investor. Now, this is the last statement. Like many people, everything he buys loses value or costs him money. Nothing he buys makes him richer. But remember, he started by saying, like many people. So that means some of us are like this. So where are you? Now, my first sentence on that, let's learn. Let's learn so that when we spend money, we know whether we're spending it right or wrong. Let's try to save some money, invest it, don't just stop at invest saving it, figure out how to invest it and earn some more money. So keep it here. Let's keep learning from Robert. I think he knows what he's talking about. Seriously, because all those things, no one talks about them. So leave a comment. What do you think? Are you zero? Zero like him? Or you could be zero without being rich first. Just zero, zero. That's how you are. You don't have the money. Nothing is moving for you. So you could be zero in a different way. He gave an example of a rich one who is a zero. I think to sort of wake us up that just because someone is driving an expensive car, living in an expensive house, especially here in USA, everything is on loan. Can you imagine? By the way, this wasn't planned. You know me. I just speak. I never knew that you could go buy, you know, a sofa, the sofa you see, like dining set on credit. Everything, someone furnishes a house, everything on credit. I didn't know you could do that. I feel like that's very sad. You buy a house, you cannot furnish it, you go get it. Now the house is on a mortgage. That's a loan. A car is on mortgage. The chairs, everything you have, they set on payment plan. You know, they give you, they say two years pay like $200 every month. Everything you are doing is on mortgage, you don't own a thing. And it's sad, actually. And they put interest on that. So, well, after you make all the monthly payments, you have nothing. And there is insurance to pay. Insurance on the car. Insurance on the house. Insurance and insurance. Health insurance. Wow. We are here in America, but remember he said it's not number one anymore. I didn't know that. I think there is too much debt. And guess who benefits? the banks. That was not intended. I just added in. So leave a comment. We need to keep, you see, he described five levels. Let's see where we're going to end, but we don't want to be here on this zero. You just use common sense and not to be on the 01. Okay, leave a comment, like the video, share it. If you know someone driving expensive cars and doing behaving this way, the way this one is behaving, send them this message. You don't have to say anything, just send them the video. Say, I think this is interesting. Add a comment. Please like the video. Like I always end them, I say, take very good care of yourself. Take very good care of your families. Take very good care of your health. Remember the links in the description and the pinned comment for the previous video and the end screen that's about to come up. Financial education, I think is what it's called. That takes you to all of them. But I'm doing one-on-one. So next video will be level 2. When you hear me, when I dress like this, it's this book. I don't like dress like this for anything else, just for this book. So when you see me like this the next time, it's going to be level 2, the level 2 investor. We finish the first one. Take a step to a better you. Bye-bye.